Hello, hello, my beautiful Taurus. Merry Christmas. Today I'm going to be doing a Christmas reading for you guys. If you celebrate, Merry Christmas. If you don't, that's okay. It is a bonus reading for you guys. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Goretti, and first I am going to cleanse our energy space. All right, so let's get going here. I'm going to remove all negative energies and entities and any evil eye from your space and mine. Thank you, it is done, and so it is. All right, my love, so I have already pulled some of the Oracle cards just to kind of get into your energy space. I will cut the decks on camera so you can see, but I always like to take a little peek at the bottom of the deck just to see what's going on. So let's see what's happening here. It says all downhill, your pace is a shifting. All right, you guys, all downhill, your pace is shifting. So I don't think it's like downhill in a bad way. I just think that things, oh my goodness, you guys, it is Mercury retrograde right now. I do think that things are moving quickly for you guys is what this is kind of saying at this time. All right. So this is my beautiful winter deck here. I absolutely love it. So bottom of the deck, we have getting together. Someone wants to connect. All right, Taurus. So definitely maybe connecting with someone. And of course, being the candy canes here, I am getting that energy of sweet, something sweet. Maybe you guys are going out for a dessert. This could be a friend, but I am getting a kind of different vibes here. I'm getting, you know, romantic vibes and stuff like that. Atop of the deck, we have keeping the faith. There is always hope. Okay, so something that you guys possibly behind that, I did notice the next card was different hats. You play several roles. And keeping the faith, there is always hope. So I feel like some of you here, there's a lot going on, especially with this time of year, with Christmas. I'm getting like some of you could be parents. There could just be lots kind of happening. Sorry, guys. I am also using my new phone and new camera. Just getting used to it. So I don't know how things look or how they sound. But you guys here, this is lots of things happening, especially with that downhill being that card underneath the deck. I feel like many of you guys, you know, are parents, possibly a mother or father. You know, you're also a sibling, you're a child to somebody. Lots going on. There's, you know, different things happening possibly at work this time of year. You're kind of juggling and wearing many hats at this time. Lots of get-togethers with different people. So I feel like the pace is really quick. Like things are just happening really quickly, and I get this like chaos feeling. And whatever it is, whatever you're juggling, all these different hats that you have to wear, whatever it is that you're juggling, that's kind of the feeling I get here. Just continue to keep the faith and know that there's always hope. So maybe it's you guys are starting to date. Maybe it's you guys, you know, having issues possibly with family or something like that. You know, it could be that maybe it's having to, you know, maybe it's at work. You guys are feeling, you know, overwhelmed, kind of, you know, taking on other people's responsibilities. Maybe too much is being put on you. Just continue to have hope. And this is the season, you guys, with Christmas. This is the season, you know, for hope. Okay. Is kind of what I want to let you guys know. Sorry, guys, getting used to this camera. You guys are my first video on my new phone. So, but you guys also, this is somebody wanting to get together with you. What I kind of get as well with the different hats, you play several roles. I feel like, you know, if somebody asks for you to go out for a coffee or a drink or, you know, a dessert or dinner or whatever it is, or just to get together, whatever it is, I feel like you guys, you know, make sure you take that person up on that offer, whether it's friendship or family or romantic, whatever it is. I just feel like you guys, you know, kind of need to get out, okay? And then bottom of the deck underneath that, we had giving and receiving, keep prosperity flowing. Okay. So, a giving of your time, receiving other people's time, a giving and receiving gifts, of course, it could be, something as well during this time. So we'll get into, the rest of the Oracle cards and get more here. So we have live playfully and with a light heart. Listen to the voice of your inner child. You guys, that's kind of, this is the bottom of the deck before I cut it. This is kind of what I was feeling. It's this like overwhelm. You guys are doing too much. You're wearing too many hats. You know, working too hard, you know, not playing enough. That's why I said, you know, if somebody asked to get together, like go. I feel like you guys aren't taking enough time to like just enjoy things. And then bottom of the deck, we have enter the temple of your truth and learn to value it. Okay. So this is kind of telling me also spending time going within. I feel like many of you guys aren't really doing that. Because the next card, the top of the deck says it is time for a change. Do not wait or put off decisions any longer. Here, I feel like some of you guys, this is a time for soul searching. This is a time for introspection, a time to go within. I think that many of you also with this, so I'm getting, guys, I'm getting so many different messages here. With the wearing the different hats, like I said, I think that many of you guys are, you know, kind of have different roles to play in your life, in your job. And this is a time for you guys to really spend a lot of time going within and value that time, you know, that alone time. Maybe it's in your car on the commute to and from work. Maybe it's, you know, after the kids go to sleep, right? Just spending that time really valuing, you know, going within, connecting to, I'm hearing, you know, source, spirit, your spirituality, your higher self, higher consciousness, you know, even just spending time meditating, whatever this is. And then it is time for a change. Do not wait or put off decisions any longer. What I kind of get with this is some of you could be facing something right now, and you don't know what direction you're going to go. You don't know what this is going to be like. Some of you are losing hope. Maybe it has to do with a job. Maybe it has to do with, you know, a marriage. I'm hearing for some of you, a relationship, whatever this is, there seems to be a decision that needs to be made. Or this is, you know, a time for change because you guys have been kind of, you know, go, 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 not playing, you know, not having fun, not connecting with other people. And this is saying that there is time for a change. So maybe this is eating healthier. Maybe this is, you know, sleeping more. Maybe this is, you know, getting together with people more, with your friends. Maybe this is having a little bit more fun. Maybe this is doing some of your hobbies. But you guys, definitely I'm feeling a lot of kind of, you know, stressful energy, a lot of overwhelm, that kind of thing. Bottom of the deck before I cut this one says harmony, ease, inner child, softness. May sweet and soft things find you. You guys can't even make this up. So you guys need to get back into that childlike wonder, you know, the sweetness of a child, maybe spending more time with your children, maybe, or nieces or nephews. Maybe it could be your fur babies. This is you guys being playful. This is you guys, you know, being in harmony. This is saying that something is out of balance. Okay. So maybe you're not spending enough time within. Maybe you're spending too much time with other people. Sorry guys, Mercury retrograde definitely affects our communication. Okay. So bottom of the deck after cutting it says you are worthy of beautiful things. The servant queen, divine, magnetic, and valuable. Some of you are giving too much and you're not receiving. You feel like this is the only way that you're valuable is by what you do, what you give to others, right? Empaths especially struggle with this. Underneath that, be patient, it will come. The sun, manifestation, power, 1111. So you guys might be seeing 1111. So whatever this is, you know, have hope, right? We saw here, keep the faith, right? Continue kind of, you know, focusing on hope. There's always hope, light at the end of the tunnel. I just heard with that one. Okay. Some of you guys, maybe you guys don't see your manifestations coming through and you guys are exhausted and you're tired. And you just want things to change. Okay. Things will change. I promise you. So next card, top of the deck, blessings and curses, psyche, self-love, and beauty. Do not be ashamed. Do not, or not of your thorns or of your flowers. So you guys, we all have negative and positive aspects. We all have our shadow side. We have our light side. This is accepting all of yourself. Some of the things that you guys have as well, like I was saying, I feel like some of you guys are working too much, wearing too many hats, giving too much, not playing enough, not connecting within enough as well. Kind of being a servant as opposed to a queen or a king. Take it how it resonates, right? And I feel like some of that, you know, being a good, loving, nurturing person, Can be a blessing, but also a curse at the same time. So this is a time right now, I feel like you guys do have to go within, spend some time going within, figure out what it is that you do value, see what kind of parts of you that is a blessing, but also a curse at the same time. And then there's some decisions here to be made, okay? I know you guys, this is kind of heavy for, you know, middle of December, you know, kind of Christmas time reading, but we'll get into the tarot and see what the tarot has to say for you guys as well. All right, messages and guidance for Taurus. Messages and guidance, what does Taurus need to know during Christmas time or the holidays, middle of December towards the end of the year? What does Taurus need to know? Messages and guidance. All right, let's see. Bottom of the deck, we have the World. So something is definitely shifting and changing. There are things coming to an end and new things beginning. And you guys, I'm getting like ringing in my ears. So that is very true. Some of you guys, this is, you know, maybe moving, maybe traveling around the world. Sorry, the deck kind of fell apart there. That's really weird. Some of you guys could feel like you're holding it all together. And if you don't, your whole world will fall apart. I just heard for some of you. Okay. So bottom of the deck, I'm actually going to lay the cards out and then I'll walk you through it. Yeah, you guys, this is a time that you really kind of need to rest. Okay. Yeah. Yep. Wow. Wow. Okay. Beautiful. All right. Yeah. Okay. Spirit, we're going to stop there. All right. So. Oh my goodness, you guys. Lots of messages here. Okay, so this was supposed to be a shorter reading, but I guess not. Center your spread. We have this Four of Swords. So this is resting, recovering, healing from something. Okay, but you guys, this is you really needing to rest and heal. Some of you guys, this could just be more sleep, more downtime. Like I said, working too hard, not playing enough. What we're aware of is the Queen of Wands. The Queen of Wands is really dynamic. The Queen of Wands really loves herself. She manifests. She's a magnetic. We did see that in the Oracle card. Being a magnet to bring things in, not working so hard. Spending time going within. She is, you know, a master manifestor, right? She's very magnetic. She's beautiful. She's male or female. Take it however it resonates. We all embody both energies. I'm just reading the energies. But and just using the terms according to, you know, what I see. But, you know, she is drawing things and magnetizing things to her. She's attractive. She's alluring. She's charismatic. She's also an entrepreneur. She could be in the spotlight as well. Okay. So many of you guys, again, with wearing many hats. So what we're seeing is many of you guys kind of have a lot going on for you right now. Okay. Which is great, but also a blessing and a curse, right? In the recent past, we have justice. So justice could be things possibly being out of balance. This could have to do with court, you know, type stuff, legal stuff. Or this is, you know, kind of, I'm getting for some of you guys, maybe some injustice, something that wasn't really right. But I'm seeing a lot of like imbalance with this card as well. And I was picking up on that already before. And then what we're not aware of is the Strength card. So this is asking for you to go within, spending that time in your inner temple, okay, going within, gaining that internal strength. And many of you, it is by taking the time to rest. Rest, heal, recover, okay? So that's what's happening there. Your advice is Eight of Wands. So this could be, so Eight of Wands is moving very quickly, okay? So like we saw that, the downhill, the skiing. Things are moving very quickly, lots, fast communication. And I feel like the advice is saying to slow down. Even though this is the advice card, what I'm getting from this is maybe some of you need to communicate. Maybe you need to tell other people that you need to slow down. Maybe you, you know, at work or at home, lots of movement. Okay. So some of you, there could be some stagnation. Maybe you're sitting at a desk all day and you might need to actually, you know, spend time, you know, moving, doing exercise, things like that. That's your advice. I feel like the advice is really slow things down. For you guys here, and the potential outcome, we have the High Priestess. So the High Priestess is all about this inner temple. It is going within. It is listening to your intuition. Okay. It is having wisdom. It is manifesting. It is going within to create. It is having that inner wisdom. It's feeling things that you're not quite seeing. It's really connecting to your spirit, your spirit self, your spirituality, your higher self, right? Whatever this is, it is going within. When I clarified it, what did we get? We got the Temperance card, patience, right? So if you guys are working on something, this is saying to have patience. Alchemy, this is balance, right? This is knowing how to balance things. The Hangman, some, kind of surrendering. Don't force it. Okay, whatever this is about, this is going to be different for everybody, but don't force it. Have faith, okay? There's always hope, so have faith, whatever it is that you're trying to create. And then we have the Empress card. So the Empress is, somebody who's very abundant, but she's also, creating something. And it's this gestation period, it's the waiting period, because she's usually pregnant with something. For somebody, for some of you guys, this could be about pregnancy, possibly. This is listening to your body, listening to the intuition of what it is that your body needs, possibly. For others of you, what I was getting with this card is not just abundance. Some of you, yeah, could be, kind of Empress energy, all four queens in one, right? You're wearing many hats. You're a mother, you're a nurturer, but you're also a creator. And so it's spending that time going within to create and manifest, having that patience, right? But also that proper alchemy, right? And then surrendering it to the divine, right? I wanted to keep going and clarifying what this was about. So we have Ace of Cups. This could have to do with your health. I don't know why I just said that. Okay. Spirit wanted to share that with someone. I heard heart health. Some of you need to get, maybe that checked. Maybe you're running, going too much. Could be, your heart racing too fast. I'm getting. This could be about love, right? For a lot of you guys, this is connecting to, the love from the divine, right? This is connecting to source energy. Again, with the inner temple connecting to that. For some of you, this has to do with self-love, with the Queen of Cups here, going within and really loving and nurturing yourself, pouring that love on yourself. Some of you guys, it is going for counseling, right? Seeking somebody that is very much nurturing and empathic. And then we also have the Magician. This is saying you have everything that you need within you to manifest and create the life that you want. The Magician is like the physical kind of work to manifest. But also the manifester, right? It's actually doing the actions, like maybe it's affirmations or visualizations. And the High Priestess is the one with that inner knowing, that trust and faith that, yes, this is coming in for me, and connecting to that divine love and knowing that divine is coming and pouring these beautiful blessings onto you guys. Okay. So let me see here. Guys, I didn't even set the timer, so I don't know what we're at. Probably a long reading, but bottom of the deck, we have Knight of Pentacles. Slow and steady wins the race. This is the tortoise and the hare, right? This is solid and stable, moving forward at a slower pace, but it is going to get you to the finish line, crossing the finish line. So the Knight of Pentacles is the only knight in the deck that crosses the finish line. Okay, so you guys do need to know that. Then we also have the Knight of Cups. So this could be you guys offering your cup of love to somebody else. This could be somebody offering their cup of love to you. This is like, the romantic knight in shining armor. So some of you guys, this could have to do with, dating, new love, new relationships, or just your relationship. Maybe things are going really slowly, but it is very stable and secure. Some of you guys, this is an offer coming in from somebody, a romantic partner. Partner offer coming in. It is coming in slow, but it is a very solid offer. Okay. So, and then right behind that, we also have Five of Wands and Four of Cups and Five of Swords. You guys have a lot of chaos going on around you, for some of you. And I know this is kind of, with the hustle and bustle, it can be a very chaotic time if you celebrate Christmas. And then we have the Three of Cups and the Chariot. Okay, so many of you guys, this is all about celebration, fun, just having a really good time. And then Chariot, you are going to move forward. Okay, things are going to happen quickly for you. Your ships are coming in. But many of you guys are really stuck in your head because what you don't see is wish fulfillment coming in. Okay, hope hope and faith, I just heard. And then right behind that, we have the Ace of Swords, which says what I just said is true, but also this is clarity. And this is you guys really connecting to the inner you, connecting to your intuition, connecting to the inner part of you, to, you know, to source energy, to the divine, to God, universe, whatever you believe in, right? Your higher self, consciousness. This is getting clarity possibly before you take action with the Knight of Swords there, but this is gaining clarity, and the only way you're going to do that is by going within. Okay, I also heard connecting to the light. Okay, whatever that means for you. But you guys, definitely lots of, you know, Five of Swords, Five of Wands, Four of Cups, like you guys, just chaos, you know, conflict, lots of things kind of going on around you. And for a lot of you, I do feel like it's internal. And I feel you guys are the ones keeping yourself stuck. You do need to get out there and have fun and celebrate. Let your hair down, I just heard. Have fun with your friends, your family, whatever it is. All right, my loves? So that's what I have for you. I am going to, Taurus, you guys have been really good for me. You know, you've been really supportive on my channel here, helping my channel to grow. So I just want to give you guys one more piece of advice with the Eight of Wands, clarifying the Eight of Wands, please. All right. Oh, yeah. Okay. So you guys, for some of you, this is also going to be very fast kind of communication, whether this is at work, whether this is family, but I do see new contracts. There are things that are going to be balanced here. Get out of your head. Stop fearing with the Nine of Swords, because we have Ace of Pentacles here. There's an offer coming in for you. Six of Wands. This is going to be victory and success for you. For some of you, this has to do with being in the spotlight, possibly, like, you know, leveling up in your job or something like that. And we have the Fool. This is going to take a leap of faith, but it's also a brand new beginning. And for you guys, some of you guys, this could be about taking a relationship to the next level. This could be in regards to your spirituality, possibly balancing yourself out. This could be you guys really kind of working hard to be kind of, you know, a leader or a teacher in some area. And for others of you, yeah, this is, you know, higher level of commitment, marriage. This is going to be something very balanced. I feel like many of you guys, you know, just confirming that to slow down, spend time going within, spend time with source energy, get yourself back to balance, okay? Some of you, this might mean going to church, possibly. This could be doing different, you know, spiritual practices, that sort of thing. And then further clarifying, we also have the King of Wands. So some of you, this could be entrepreneurship. Yeah, wearing a lot of hats. You guys have been really working hard. This could be somebody coming in for you if it is, you know, commitment. This person is really, you know, dynamic, attractive, alluring, charismatic. Somebody possibly that you could be dating. You guys have been waiting for your ships to come in, possibly for a commitment or something like that. And you guys, the Chariot card here, you guys are definitely moving forward with this. For others of you guys, if it is about, you know, work or something like that, this is saying, you know, you need to spend time not just working, you know, possibly business, whatever this is, or a higher level position, but you also need to have fun too, okay? Your ships are coming in. You guys have put in the work. Things are moving definitely very quickly. I just heard many of you need to spend this time resting, because things are going to happen really fast, okay? You don't see this coming, and I just got chills saying that. All right, my loves? So we're going to do an angel message. This card came flying out when I was pre-shuffling. It says the person you're asking about is trustworthy. So some of you could be asking about, you know, a potential friend, you know, romantic partner, you know, this a new person possibly, or somebody at work, family member. This person is trustworthy, whoever you're asking about. Bottom of the deck before I cut it says prayer will help the situation. You guys need to spend more time going within. Prayer is also not begging the universe or God. Prayer is really having that faith and belief that what it is that you want is coming. Okay, so top of the deck, we have you and your loved ones are safe. So whatever this is, I just heard some of you worrying about, you know, finances, possibly. Some of you guys are moving, maybe worrying about where you're going to live, that sort of thing. Nothing to fear. You guys and your family are safe. Your loved ones are safe and protected as well. Bottom of the deck, we have make a commitment. So this could be somebody making a commitment to you, right? This is that commitment card here. Higher level of commitment, contracts, This could be something, you know, because we did see justice in the recent past. Some of you guys are dealing with like legal issues, custody, things like that. Taurus, I am so sorry. This is a very deep reading. I meant for it to be really light and fun, but make a commitment. And what I just heard is making a commitment to yourself. But some of you guys could be making a commitment to another person in relationship. Like I said, l higher level, you know, whatever that next level is for you. Somebody making a commitment to you. This could be committing to a job or to a business, a venture or whatever this is. But I heard for a lot of you guys, this is making a commitment to loving yourself and pouring that love and blessings on yourself, taking the time to really rest, have fun, enjoy life. Stop and smell the roses, all right, Taurus? I feel like Taurus, you guys have really, you know, I just heard nose to the pavement, right? Like you guys have been working really hard. And during this time, during this holiday season, whether you celebrate Christmas or not, take this opportunity to just slow down, rest, celebrate, have fun, join in festivities, right? Whatever it is, that is what spirit is saying to you today. All right, my loves? So if you guys, sorry guys, Mercury retrograde is really bad. I'm really being affected. If you guys can hit the like button, share this video, hit the bell icon so you get notified of new videos because there's been an issue with that with my channel recently. You know, I just did a video for that as well. You know, comment down below. I love hearing from you guys. I respond to all of your comments. And also, you guys, if you're new to my channel, if you haven't subscribed yet, please go ahead and do so. I would absolutely love to have you here as part of this ever-growing a butterfly family. And you guys, like I said, Merry Christmas if you celebrate. If not, happy holidays. Enjoy the rest of December. And as always, you guys, I wish you all peace, love, and light. Until next time. Bye-bye.